This is Britain's Got More Talent, and we are in Scotland. Now, I know this sounds like a stereotype, but the locals here actually dress up in kilts, paint their faces blue, and then shout freedom.
Freedom!
Told you, I'm not making these things up. Before the auditions begin, there's time to drag David away from his adoring fans to have a quick catch-up. Do you know something? Have you had this response at any time in your life?
Yes, I have.
Really?
And let's be honest, it's to see Anton Deck. In this sort of list, Anton Deck, Simon Cowell, Amanda...
Go on.
Alicia.
Yeah.
Me. That's it.
What was your big break? How did you get into entertainment?
I had two jobs early on when I left university. One was writing scripts for Anton Deck on their show, The Anton Deck Show. And the second, I did a show on Sky One called Games World, which was a computer game show. And I used to give out the tips for various different characters.
And Little Britain, is that finished now?
For now, but, you know, you never know when people might be wanting more. It's a hard one. It's really tough.
Do you think you'll work again with Matt?
Yes, I hope so. Obviously, there's a real... we have a really good chemistry together and a great... We've, you know, produced some really good work together and some really terrible stuff as well, but some good stuff.
Oh, my goodness, hello!
Are you staying over this evening?
No. Going back on Simon's got a plane.
You haven't got
me and Alicia flew up on his plane, yeah.
With him? Why can't I get on the jet?
We did discuss it because there wasn't actually a spare seat.
Hello.
How are you feeling the audition's going to go?
Yeah, I think it's going to be okay because I'm singing a song a lot of people know. If I can get the people on my side and get the judges to act as well, then I think I'll be a winner.
Hi, I'm Rob King, I'm 61, and today I'm going to be singing.
Nice to see you, Rob. Yeah. And what do you do for a living?
I'm a lollipop man. Boom, 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 boom. I'm taking the competition very serious. It's a bit like Everest, and I want to climb to the top.
I just noticed you've got really big hands.
Yes, yeah, I do have. 10 inches across.
Look at that. Oh, bless your heart! Could your hand cover my face?
Yeah, I think we could try that.
Try.
Like an octopus.
Yeah. Oh, that quite hurt. Put your hands on, put your hands on. Now, what is it you're doing today?
I'm going to sing.
Stop. What's he going to sing? Have a guess. Carry on, tell him.
I am going to sing the Proclaimers 500 Mile.
Well, listen.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is on your hand.
Stop.
Nice one! Whoa, high 10. Yeah.
So, what's your name, please?
My name is Rob King.
You're singing, I guess.
Yeah.
You look at the charts now, and who do you see yourself like?
I'm like me. I am Rob King. I'm not like anybody else. I'm not trying to be anybody else. I'm Rob King.
Take it away, Rob King.
Simon.
You look like you were loving that. What did you think? Do you see him having a big future in the record business?
No. Amanda?
You know, you got everyone on their feet. It was a crowd pleaser. It was good fun, and I like you.
Alicia.
Thank you, Rob King. That was just so much fun. David?
You're not like other people in the charts right now. Which is what I like about you. I'm gonna say... yes.
I am going to say... no.
Alicia?
It's a yes from me.
Whatever you're on, I want some. It's a yes.
Stop! Stop! It's that time of the show that you've all been waiting for! It's Where's Wally? Ups! Starring our very own judge, David Williams! Each week we challenge you to find out where David's hiding, and we've cleverly called it Where's Wally?
Hi there!
Ups! But where's Wally Ups hiding today? He's in an underwater aquatic landscape! You have until his head reaches the buzzer to find him! Your time starts now! Can you place him? Have a go just for the halibut. He's caught to be somewhere. Where's Wally? Your time's finished. Did you find him? There's Wally. Tune in next week for more Where's Wally?
Hi there, welcome to Britain's Got Talent. What's your name?
It's Colin McLeod.
Hello, mate.
Hello, Stephen, how are you?
Very good, thank you. What do you do?
I am a mentalist.
Yes! I love mentalists.
Good.
Tell them what a mentalist is.
A mentalist, essentially, is someone who can read people's minds.
That is right. Is that what it's called, a mentalist?
Yeah, it does mean something very different in Glasgow, I'm aware of that. I'm able to tell people things like date of birth, phone numbers, street names, names of people they first kissed, PIN numbers.
Could you have a guess? Oh, what my PIN number is.
Yeah?
How did you know that? 6439. That's right. You've got to do this again. Matt, think about your PIN code. Go on, do what you did to me. Do what you did to me. Right, you've got it?
I think we'll go with that.
Right, right, don't show him it.
Okay.
Say your PIN code.
1642.
Show them!
1642.
Yes! What are you going to do today?
Today I'm going to attempt to influence the four judges.
In what way?
Using something quite personal to them, their biographies.
Right.
And I'm hoping that they're going to end up from one of the biographies choosing the exact word that I think they're going to pick.
So, are you nervous about things going wrong?
It could either go really, really well and work perfectly, or it's going to be an absolute disaster.
All the best.
Thank you, Stephen.
Cheers, mate. Yeah.
Hello, what's your name?
My name's Colin McLeod.
What's your day job?
I am one of the owners of a motivational speaking company, essentially.
Fabulous.
Yes.
Do you think you could help Simon? Because he's very shy.
You think you can win this show with this act?
I'm hoping that I do have the skills and abilities to do well in Britain's Got Talent, yes.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Thank you very much.
Good
luck. Before we do this, can you please welcome to the stage Ant and Dec?
Oh, we're on.
What?
Guys, I'm going to show you the words that I'm hoping we end up on are either printed or the word bottom. We've got four books as well. We've got the autobiography of Simon Cowell.
It's a good read.
Amanda Holden.
Oh, yeah.
Alicia Dixon.
Yeah.
And better than that, we have David Williams, the boy in the dress. So, four choices. David, which book do you want to use?
My book.
You want to use your book?
Yes, it's the only work of literature amongst them.
Alicia, I'm going to run through the pages. Please say stop whenever you like.
Stop.
That's exactly where she said stop,
yeah.
Correct? Perfect. Yeah. Amanda, which side do you want to use, the right or the left?
Left.
That's the left here. And I'm going to run my business card down the page. Simon, as I bring the card down the page, you need to say stop whenever you like. I'm going to run my fingers down. Whenever you like, Simon, please say the word stop.
Stop.
Right here. Can you please, both of you, look in and tell them what's the biggest word, the longest word on the line that you can see there?
Revealing.
Say that again?
Revealing.
Revealing. Not the word printed or bottom. No.
No.
I'm going to stop lying to you. It wasn't actually about these words here. If I just take this part off here, this actually reads...
No way.
I just want to say, Mum, I'm really sorry.
OK. David.
Oh, I'd love to ask you, how did you do that?
That's the very first time it's ever worked.
I wouldn't rely on your ask, darling, for entertainment. But thank you for waxing on this occasion.
No problem.
I think we're going to vote. David.
It's a yes.
Thank you.
Amanda?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Yes, for me too.
Thank you very much.
I had no idea how you did it, so I'm going to say yes.
Thank you very much.
How the hell does he do that?
Nicely done. Can you tell me some other stuff that's going to happen today?
I think one of the things definitely going to happen is that a man dressed as a rocker will meet someone dressed as a Scottish flag and ask them for a Kit Kat.
Don't be ridiculous.
All right, man, get any Kit Kats?
Oh, yes!
Just for the hell of it, go on, give us another one.
We'll say a man with an accordion will shout, "Och, I the new," standing on a zebra crossing.
You must say I'm stupid.
No.
Och, I the new.
Do I look stupid?
I'm telling you, it's going to happen.
Yeah, right.
Still to come.
I'm into nuts.
Never heard one like that!
Absolutely no sense of humour!
Tanya's bitten by a spider!
You are really getting on my nerves.